The Lord.
赞美神。
I am back in Tainan.
我回到台南。
I'm so happy to be back.
我很高兴回到台南。
And I thank you for your prayers.
谢谢大家的祷告。
Thank you for your support.
谢谢大家的支持。
The last, few years, I'm back and forth to Germany.
在过去的几年，我就一直台南，德国这样来回跑。
And I need to tell you, it is a very big blessing for our family.
我要告诉你们，这是一个非常大的祝福。
Three years ago,
三年前
，I need to speak Chinese to my children.
我必须用中文跟孩子们沟通。
Because my children don't speak my language.
因为小孩不太讲这个德语。
I don't know if you can imagine if you cannot talk to your children in Chinese.
那你可以想象你不能跟孩子用中文说话的那种感觉吗？
There's so many things I want to tell them.
他有很多事情想要告诉他们。
So after these 3 years now, I really speak German with them.
但是这三年过后，我真的跟他们用德文沟通。
And they speak German to me.
他们也用德语回应我。
It's a big breakthrough.
这个是很大的突破。
And it's a very, important for me.
对我来讲是非常重要的。
To be able to communicate with them.
能够跟他们沟通这件事很重要。
And I think that God really, closed one important, time frame now.
那我觉得神现在好像似乎有一个关闭这样的一个时间的这样的一个界限。
So that I can now be more back here in Taiwan.
所以现在呢，我会比较多的时间在台湾。
Once in a while, I still will go back for a short time.
那我偶尔还是会短期的回到德国。
To stay, you know, to keep the family connection.
就是跟家人有一些互动。
But now I'm much more here back in.
但我现在会比较在台湾比较多时间。
Especially the whole summer, I will be here.
特别是这个暑假，我都会在这里。
And Simu will come in 3 weeks, and the children will come in 5 weeks.
师母三个礼拜后会回来，小孩子则是五个礼拜之后会回来。
And so we will have a good time together the next few months.
那我会跟大家会有美好的时光，在这三个月。
Yeah, and as you see that Pastor Tai, he is not here.
那大家可以看到那个万牧师不在了。
Because we give him a mission sabbatical.
我们给他一个就是安息又有服事的这样的一个事工。
In a few days he will go to Germany.
在几天之后他会去德国。
And he will serve the Chinese churches there.
他会侍奉华人的教会。
And also will take some time to refresh.
也会花点时间再重新的让自己能够更加的有活力。
And we believe this is very good and very important.
我觉得这个很重要，而且也很棒。
Especially if you pastor for a long time without any big break.
特别是如果你服侍一段那么长的时间却没有休息的时候。
So for us, when we do something different, we will get new inspiration.
当我们转变一下这样的事工，做一些新的事，我们会重新的再得力。
And I think it's very biblical.
这个也符合圣经的。
First of all, God says every week, one day you should rest.
特别神说就是我们一个礼拜要休息一天。
And it's not easy.
这不太容易。
Right? Some of us, we still want to do some work.
有些人就是还是觉得要继续做。
Maybe still a chance to make a little bit more money.
特别会觉得说多做一天多赚一点钱。
Or maybe to just, you know, work in the house.
或者是甚至就是带回家工作。
But Old Testament is very strong on the rest on the Sabbath.
可是旧约呢，其实非常强调那个安息日的重要。
Because God knows our heart.
因为神知道我们的心。
He knows it's difficult.
他知道我们的困境。
So very often He trains us.
特别所以他会特别透过一些事情来训练我们。
Starting training the Israelites in the wilderness.
譬如说在那个旷野训练以色列人。
Because when the manna came down,
那个玛纳来降下的时候。
There was one day where there was no manna coming down.
会有一天没有玛纳降下。
Even people were trying to find something.
如果有人想要出去找那个玛纳的话。
They didn't find anything.
他们找不到的。
In the end, they were tired.
最后其实他们其实是很累的。
And maybe disappointed.
甚至有点失望。
But those who trusted God,
但是那些信靠神的
And they rested the one day.
他们就安息了一天
They refreshed.
他们重新得力
And had again strength for the coming week.
那重新再有力量的面对接下来的那个礼拜
I think God wants us to rest.
我相信神是需要我们是希望我们安息的
At the right time.
就是在正确的时间来安息
Then he also gave the Sabbath year.
甚至他在圣经在他的话语当中也提到那个安息年。
So every 7 years,
在每七年的时候
，especially for farming,
特别是在那个做农业的这些
，he says take a rest.
他说要休息
，even give the soil a rest.
同时，这样的休息其实是也是给土壤的休息。
If you are a farmer, you know how important it is that the soil can, you know, regain the strength.
那如果你是农夫的话，你就知道那一年的那个休养生息是多么的重要，因为那个是让土壤重新再度肥沃的那个机会。
And then 7 times 7 years.
那七，七七四十七个七年。
He also gave a jubilee year.
他也给了一个喜年。
And even more rest, right?
那个休息更长了。
So God really wants us to rest.
神真的希望我们好好休息。
At the right time.
在正确的时间。
To regain strength.
再重新得力。
It's very important.
这非常重要。
And so also today, this festival of Pentecost.
那今天也是五旬节。
In the Old Testament concept of festivals.
这是也是一个旧约的一个节庆的概念。
It is a day of rest.
这是一个休息的一个日子。
And we can read this together in Leviticus 23.
好，我们一起来立位记这个章节，我们一起来念。
Leviticus 23.
在二十三章。
If you're a long time in our church,
如果你在教会很久的话
，You know we often read from this chapter.
我们常读这个经节。
It's a very important chapter.
这是一个非常重要的经节。
Don't think it's boring.
别觉得这很无聊。
Oh, don't think. Oh, again.
不要想说哦，又来了。
Because that's God's purpose.
因为这是神的一个目的。
To repeat and repeat and repeat.
神的目的就是一直反复反复，希望我们知道那个重要。
Every time we learn something new.
每一次我们学到新的东西。
So today, we read again.
所以今天我们再读。
In Leviticus 23.
好，我们再次的读这样的一个立位记二十三章。
And we read from verse 15 to 16.
我们从十五节到
No, 到十六，
十六而已。
15 to 16, two verses.
十五到十六节。
Let's read that together, okay?
好，我们一起来念。
一二三。
你们要从安息日的次日，献禾捆为摇祭的那日算起，要满了七个安息日，到第七个安息日的次日，共祭五十天，又要将新束祭献给耶和华。
So at that time, it was also a first fruit festival.
在那个时候也是初熟节。
And what fruit?
什么果子呢?
What kind of fruit?
什么样的果子呢?
Okay. It was wheat.
那是小麦的一个节庆。Okay.
Before, 50 days before,
在五十天之前,
there was another festival.
也有另外一个节日。
If you go to verse 9,
如果你从第九节开始看
的话, right? There was also a first fruit festival.
有一个节日叫做初熟的那个庄稼，也是初熟节。
At that time, it was the first fruit was barley.
那个时候的那个初熟的那个果子是那个大麦。
So every time there's kind of a new fruit coming up.
所以每一个时节都有一个新的一个。
Or harvest time.
一个新的一个收割的季节。
God wants part of that, the first fruit of that.
那神希望有这样的一个初熟的果子。
It's a very important principle.
这是一个非常重要的原则。
Why the first fruit?
为什么要初熟的果子呢?
Because God wants to teach us.
因为神要教导我们。
Right at the beginning when we receive something.
就是在那个最开始我们收到的东西。
Teach us that the blessing comes from Him.
让我们要明白，就是那个我们第一个开始收到的东西是来自于神的。
The blessing comes from God.
那个祝福是来自神的。
Now today we are no longer farmers.
那今日我们已经大部分不是农夫。
When we get harvest, it means we get our salary, right?
所以那个收割的季节呢，就变成是我们领薪水的时候。
So when we get our salary,
所以当我们领薪水的时候
，we also give our first fruit.
我们也同样把那个最开始拿到的那个东西献上。
Many of us give our tithe.
所以很多人就会献上十一奉献。
And usually we give it right at the first time when we receive the salary.
通常我们就是那个薪水一拿到的时候，我们就献上我们的十一奉献。
That would be in the same principle, right?
那是同样的原则。
When we receive,
我们收到
by faith,
我们靠着信心收到这样的一个供应。
To thank God with our tithe,
我们也是用我们的十一奉献来感谢神他的
供应。And to say we trust you,
来表达说我们相信神。
We don't afraid that we don't have enough,
我们不会担忧说我们不够。
But we give to Him,
我们就把这样的一个
the first fruit
出熟，或者是我们先拿到的这样的一个薪水先献上给神。
And saying, Lord, we trust that you always give us enough.
然后心中怀有就是说感谢神，神你给我们总是足够的。
This is also what they learned here.
这里也是在这里也是同样的学习。
And look at now verse 22. It's very interesting.
我们来看那个二十二节，这里很有趣。
It says, when you reap the harvest of your land, do not reap to the very edges of your field, or gather the gleanings of your harvest. Leave them for the poor and the alien. I am the Lord your God.
在这里说到，在你们的地收割庄稼，不可割尽田角，也不可拾取所遗落的，要留给穷人和寄居的。我是耶和华你们的神。
So not just giving the first fruit,
那不是把出熟的果子献上而已。
But he's telling them, don't harvest everything.
而且他还提醒我们不要把所有的东西都收割完毕。
Just some of the edges, just leave it for the poor people.
那些田间的就留下来给穷人。
So actually that was convenient.
这样实际上是还蛮方便的。
Because the edges are more difficult to harvest.
因为边边角角反而是比较难收割的部分。
But also God wants to tell them.
那这个神也是透过这来告诉我们。
I give you more than enough.
我给你的是远超过你所想的。
I give you so much that you can share with others.
我给你是足够的，以至于你可以分享给其他的人。
You are rich.
你是富足的。
Now we need to learn that.
我们也必须学习这个。
Later we will talk about what does rich really mean.
等一下我们会谈论到富足真正的意义是什么。
But at that time they learned.To not to be greedy, right?
所以在那个年，在那个时代呢，其实他们要学习不要过度的贪婪。
Okay, leave something for the poor.
要留一些给穷人。
Give your first fruit to God.
把出熟的果子献给神。
You have enough.
你是足够的。
Look at the last word of this verse.
最后的那个字眼，就是二十二节最后的那一句。我是耶和华你们的神。
我是耶和华你们的。I'm the Lord your God. Why he write this, right?
那为什么要写这句话呢
？Why?
为什么
？We know that.
我们都知道。
But he remind us.
但是他再次的提醒我们。
Leave something for the poor.
你要留一些给穷人。
Because I am your God.
因为我是你的神。
And because I am your God.
因为我是你的神。
I will take care of you.
我会照顾你。
So he kind of.Encourages us to trust him.
所以他在透过这句呢，鼓励我们要信靠神。
When we walk in God's way,
当我们走在神的道路上
，this is the condition.
这是一个很重要的条件。
Okay? We cannot just do anything, cheat people or something, and then believe God will provide for me.
那我们在在我们的生命当中，我们不可能就是欺骗别人，然后同时也说啊相信神他会供应我。
I don't think it's a magic formula.
这个我不认为是一个很一个很有
不是魔术对不对？
魔术的方程式吗
？It's not like okay, we say the right word, then we'll get something.
哦
，It's not like this, right?
哦，他不是我们说了一个。很像一个魔术的一个字，我们就会得到那个东西。
Like I said, in Jesus' name.
哦，就像比如我们说奉主耶稣的名求的时候
，I just get it.
我就会得到的。
I don't think so.
我不认为是这样。
No, I think God wants us first to walk with Him.
我相信神要我们第一个所做的就是与他同行。
To walk in His ways.
而且是走在他的心意上。
To learn discernment.
而且就是要让我们能够有分辨的心。
To have a heart like God.
要我们要有一个基督的心
，to love people，
要爱人
，to be willing to sacrifice，
甚至要愿意牺牲。
Then God promises us，
这时候神才应许我们。
I am the Lord your God，
我是你的神。
I am
你们的神。
耶和华，
我是耶和华你们的神。
This is very important. It's very important.
这很重要。
So when our heart is right before God, we don't need to fear. We don't need to receive criticism from others. We don't need to fulfill expectation of others. Because there are so many different expectations. Your spouse,
你的配偶
your children,
你的孩子
your mother,
你的妈妈
your father,
你的爸爸
your mother-in-law,
你的这个
岳母 ，your father-in-law，
你的岳父
，grandpa，
好，你的这个祖父
，your boss，
你的老板
，your school，
你的学校
，oh， you're in touch with so many people，
你接触很多人
，everybody have different expectation，
每个人都也许对你有不同的期待
，can be very chaotic，
可以非常多的不同
，how to find peace。
那你怎么找到那样的一个平安呢
？To walk with God，
你就与神同行。
To hear this voice，
去听他的声音。
That God says， I am the Lord your God，
因为神说我是耶和华。
I will take care of you，
我会照顾你。
You will have enough，
你一定会足够的。
That's why we start always with worship on Sunday。
所以为什么我们礼拜天都要来敬拜
？To readjust our life，
就是重新调整我们的眼光。
To say, Lord, you are the most important in my life。
我们要宣告神，你是在我们生命当中最重要的。
I want to worship you。
我要敬拜你。
And in this relationship，
这样的一个关系
，that God will also let us see our own heart。
那么这样的一个关系的时候，神也让我们看到，我们的心是不是跟他是连接的
？Let us see our sin。
也让我们看到我们自己的罪
，so we can bring it to God。
所以我们能够把我们的罪带到神的面前
，and repent，
然后悔改
，and then make things right with God，
然后来重新的来修正自己的
，and walk with Him again，
来修正自己的行为，然后再度的与他同行。
So first fruit is very important。
所以初熟这个果子很重要。
And then there was the first fruit of the Torah of the Word。
所以一开始的时候是那个就是妥拉，就是那个初熟的果子是妥拉。
So at Mount Sinai, it's not the first time God speaks to His people, okay?
在西乃山上其实不是神第一次跟人他的百姓说话。
But it was a very important time of speaking to the people.
但是那个时间是非常重要的一个神对百姓说话的时间。
He gave many instruction.
他给了非常多的一个指引。
Also the Ten Commandments.
也同时在十诫这个也是在那个时候宣告。
And many of these commandments, maybe we also feel, we also would know it if even God doesn't speak to us.
这个实际其实有些时候我们很多人都已经知道，如果神没有说的话，我们也知道。
Like honor your parents, right?
像比如说要孝敬你的父母。
Maybe with common sense, we also know that.
也许在我们的常识，我们都知道。
But that's not the point.
但是这不是重点。
God is just affirming.
上帝要再重新的再坚定我们这样的信心。
He created us.
他创造了我们。
He created the world.
他创造了这个世界。
He put even this heart into our body.
他甚至将这个心摆放在我们的身体。
So if something seems natural for us to do,
所以有些时候我们觉得这个事情是很自然去做的时候
it's still from God.
这也是从神而来的。
Because God created us this way.
因为神就是创造我们
是这样的方式。So He gave us this instruction.
他给了这样的一个指引。
First fruit.
初熟的果子。
Then when we move on to the New Testament,
所以当我们在进入这个新约的时候
we come to Acts chapter 2.
我们看到使徒行传
Acts chapter 2.
第二章
Remember before we sing a song together?
记得我们一起有唱过一个诗歌
我等候你是吗 Okay, 我等候你 I wait on you, right?
我等候你
It's a Pentecost song.
这是一个五旬节的歌
Why? Because the disciples, they went to the upper room.
那因为那个时候门徒要聚集在所谓的
马可楼 And then they waited on God.
他们那时候是在等候神
And that was very important.
而且那时候很重要
Because Jesus told them to do so.
因为是耶稣要他们这么做的
Jesus didn't say, okay, just now start something.
那耶稣没有说，哎，你们就开始做一件事嘛。
Actually, sometimes that's what we want to do, right?
有些时候我们是很想这样做。
It's very hard to wait.
对，其实等候是很困难的。
I learned this when I'm back in Germany.
我在德国的时候学到了这一点。
I love to be a pastor.
我很喜欢当牧师。
I love to be with people.
我也很喜欢跟人群在一起。
But in Germany, very often, I just need to do homework with the children.
可是在德国呢，我却是要跟小孩子一起做功课。
And sometimes I serve in some churches.
有些时候我去服侍一些教会。
But not too much.
但不是太多。
So I was often alone.
所以我其实还蛮孤单的。
Want to do something?
我想要做很多事啊。
And the Lord always says, "Wait on me."
但是神就告诉我说要等候他。
Wait on me.
要等候。
It's not easy.
不太容易。
Sometimes we want to do.
其实有些时候我们都很想要先冲去做事情。
But if we go without God,
但是如果我们去做的时候是没有神的时候
we often do the wrong thing.
我们其实都会做错
So waiting on God is very important.
所以等候神是很重要的
Until we hear his voice.
直到我们听到他的声音
Until he know that now is the time to move.
直到我们听到说他说这个是可以走的时间
So that's what happened here.
所以这个发生了什么事呢
Can we read here the first four verses?
我们先来念第四节，使徒行传第二章第四节，
一到四，
一到四，
一到四 ，one to four we read together， OK？
一到四，好。五旬节到了，门徒都聚集在一处，忽然从天上有响声下来，好像一阵大风吹过，充满了他们所坐的屋子，又有舌头如火焰显现出来，分开落在他们个人头上。他们就都被圣灵充满，按着圣灵所赐的口才说起别国的话来。
We read the scripture last time I'm here, remember?
上一次我在这边讲到的时候，我们有念过这个经节。
So I'm not repeating myself.
所以我不重复了。我自己不重复。
It's very different today.
但是今天不太一样。
Last time we talked about it's the start of the church.
上一次我是讲到那个。教会的建造
And that's true.
那个是对的。
It's also a first fruit festival.
那个也是初熟节的概念。
Because when the Spirit comes,
因为当圣灵来的时候
the Holy Spirit is also a person of the Trinity.
那圣灵也是三者的
三位一体
三位一体的其中一位。
So it's a person.
这是一个人。
有一个 we have a professor here. How do you say 人吗？
我们有一个。魏格哦，魏格
，Thank
okay,
you, thank you, okay, good, thank you for the help.
Yeah.
So that means if the Holy Spirit lives in us, it's actually God lives in us.
所以如果圣灵住在我们如果有一个圣灵的话，那就是表示有一个圣灵住在我们当中。
That means God lives in us.
那表示神也住在我们当中。
Okay, so if God lives with us,
如果神跟我们同住在一起
，and we go out and minister,
那如果我们去服事事
，we minister in the Spirit.
我们就是有圣灵的带领来服事这样的
事。That means God is working through us.
那也代表着神透过我们来做这样的
事。And so after this New Testament Pentecost,
所以在这个经节五旬节
，the disciples established churches.
在这个之后呢，这个门徒就建立了这个
教会。
教会。
And then people believe in Jesus.
所以人们开始信耶稣。
And they, in a way, resurrect with Jesus.
用另外一种方式就是同与这个耶稣复活。
So they are first fruit.
那所以那个也是代表初熟的果子。
So it's a first fruit festival also.
所以这也是初熟节的概念。
The giving of the Spirit.
献上那个圣灵。
Yeah. So, when we go to verse 16 and 17.
如果我们来看那个十六节。还有十七节
That is a Peter explaining of what happens.
所以彼得这时候就来说明发生了什么事
Because at that time many people didn't know what's going on.
所以在那个时候其实大家不太知道发生了什么事
They hear people speak in different kind of languages.
因为他们听到每个人都讲不同的乡话
And also it looks like they are drunk.
看起来好像他们喝醉了。
But Peter says, no, they are not drunk.
那彼得就说不，他们没有喝醉哦。
It's the fulfillment of an Old Testament prophecy.
那是一个就是要应验旧约的一个预言。
From the book of Joel.
从这个约珥书来应验的一个预言。
So this is what say in verse 16 and 17.
所以这就是十六跟十七所要传达的。
Let's read this together.
所以我们一起来念十六节跟。
Okay, 一二三。
这正是先知约珥所说的。神说在末后的日子我要将我的灵浇灌凡有血气的你们的儿女要说预言你们的少年人要见异象老年人要做异梦
Amen. So we can see a few things in this passage.
就我们可以看到一些东西在这样的一个经节当中
First of all, there are many different languages spoken.
首先是有很多的乡话在这个当中一直在发生
It means God addressing all kinds of people, different kinds of people.
这代表神对不同的人说不同的话。
With different background.
而且有不同的背景。
So when God pours out His Spirit.
所以神把那样的一个圣灵摆放在 我们的生命当中的
时候 is not just for the Israelites.
那不是只有给以色列人。
Not just for the Taiwanese.
不是只有给台湾人。
Or for the Germans.
或者给德国人。
For everybody.
它是给所有的人。
Okay, no matter what your background is.
不论你的背景是什么。
You're poor or rich.
不论你是贫穷或者是有钱的。
You are smart or you are simple.
不论你是这个聪明或者是愚笨的。
It's for everyone.
它是给每一个人的。
And also, it's for all generations.
同样，它也是给每一个年世代。
It says here for the sons, for the daughters.
它在这里说有给那个儿女，也有给那个少年人。
For the young men.
也有给少年人。
Also for the old men.
也有给老年人。
And this is very important.
这很重要。
That we learn to walk together in one spirit.
这个很重要，是因为我们要学习如何用一个合一的灵，然后一起同行。
The unity.
那个合一。
Not just between different people.
不是就是只有跟不同的人合一。
But between different age groups.
同时也跟不同的世代来合一。
Our vision this year is to become a family.
我们的意向就是要成为一个家庭。
Now this is not easy.
这不太容易。
You know, because family, the ideal is we trust each other.
因为这不太容易，因为在家庭里面，其实那个理想的状态是我们彼此要互相信任。
Okay, but you cannot just say, "Oh, because we're the same church, we just trust each other."
但你不可能就是很简单的说啊，因为我们同一个教会，所以我们就彼此相信。
Or because this is a Christian, so I trust.
也不可能说，哎，他是基督徒，我就相信他了。
Trust needs time.
其实信任要建立信任关系是需要时间的。
But still, it is our vision.
但是。尽管是需要时间，我们还是要有这样的意向。
If we say we want to learn to trust each other,
如果我们说我们要学习彼此信靠的话，
two things need to happen.
有两件事必须要发生。
First of all, we need to spend time to know each other.
第一个是我们必须要花时间彼此培养那样的一个情感。
Know other people's strength and know other people's weakness.
我们必须要透过这样的相处，了解别人的长处跟他的一个缺点。
When we know each other's weakness,
当我们知道他软弱的那个地方的
时候， we will not be disappointed.
我们就不会这么样的失望。
We will not say, "Ah, oh, this person like this, oh, terrible."
我们就不会说，哦，这个人怎么这样啊，真的太糟糕了。
No, we will say, "I know he has this difficulty."
那我们如果了解的话，我们就知道，哎，我们知道他是因为有某些困难的。
I will help him.
我可以帮助他。
I will cover him.
我会遮盖他。
But also, we need to know ourselves.
那同时，我们也需要了解我们自己。
Where do we need to change?
我们需要哪个地方要做改变呢
？To become a trustworthy person.
改变成为一个别人可以信靠的人。
And you know, there's one sign.
你知道有一个有一个这个。Continue.
Okay, I know it's not easy. I can sometimes feel when I say something that's not easy. Okay, what I want to say is this. If people feel safe in your presence,
如果人们觉得你在的时候是很安全的，
this is a good sign. This is a good condition.
这就是一个好的现象，这是一个好的状况。
That means that they trust you, right?
那表示他们信靠你。
That you're a trustworthy person.
你是一个值得信靠的人。
Now, think about with which person you feel very safe.
好，如果你觉得跟这个人，
你想一想跟谁？
你想想跟谁在一起，你会觉得比较安全。
Okay, and then maybe there are some people you're afraid.
有些人你跟他在一起，你会很害怕。
Maybe you're afraid to hurt him.
因为你担心会说到某些话伤他。
And then this person explodes.
这个人可能就会爆发出来了。
我害怕我讲不对的话，他就爆炸。Right? 有没有这样子吗？Did you ever realize this? 有 okay, right? Maybe your boss.
也许是你的老板。
Maybe your spouse.
Maybe 是你的这个配偶会是这种情况。
But if you are this person, okay?
如果你是这样的人的话。
If people afraid of you.
如果别人害怕你的话。
It's not good.
这样就不太好。
You can be strict.
你可以非常的就是
严格 okay, 严格 is not wrong, right?
严格没有什么错
but it needs to come with grace.
但是要伴随着恩典
it needs to come with love.
也同时要有爱
my son had a very strict teacher in school.
我的小孩有一个很严格的老师
very strict.
非常的严格
people, if If you go to 南大附校 you know which teacher this is.
如果你有小孩念南大附小，就知道哪一个老师是很严格的。
OK， 就这一位。
就这一位。
But now Ander looks back.
那现在安德回来的话。
And he very thankful.
他非常感恩。
He says it was good I received this teaching.
我很感谢这个老师这样的教导。
Because this teacher, even he was strict.
因为这个老师虽然很严格。
But he was fair.
但是他是公平的
okay,、to everyone the same strict.
他对每一个人都是严格
And in a way can also say he wants the best for the students.
用一个另外一个角度来看，其实就是他希望每个孩子都能够呈现他们最好的那一面。
So he was, you are not really afraid of the teacher himself. You're just afraid of maybe being,do a mistake and be punished.
所以其实有些时候我们不是怕那个老师，而是怕我们做错什么事情，要不被老师骂。
So it means the teacher not get personal.
那个老师并不是针对某个人。
He doesn't say, "Are you not a good person?"
他不是针对某个小孩说你不好。
He says, "You need to, do this right."
他就是告诉学生说你要做对这个事情。
In order that you learn that, I will give you extra homework.
好，如果你因为要 做好要做对，所以我会给你额外的工作。
So you still feel safe, right?
所以你还是会感觉到安全吗？
Yeah, you know he's right.
因为你知道老师这样的要求是对的，所以你就做。
But you still feel safe.
那这个你就会不会害怕，你就觉得很安全。
People need to feel safe in your presence.
因为所以其实我们希望你在的时候，其实人们是可以感觉到那个安全的。
This is a good sign.
这是一个很好的一个现象。
When we have the Holy Spirit,
如果我们有圣灵的话
when God lives in us,
如果神住在我们里面
when this love of God overflows,
所以如果这样的一个神的爱能够满溢出来的时候
then when you speak to people,
所以当你跟别人讲话的时候
when you help people,
当你帮助别人的时候
when you teach people,
当你教导别人的时候
it's from the Holy Spirit,
那就是一个从圣灵而来的教导
it's from that overflow,
那个是一个满溢出来的教导
it's like,God's teaching.
那就好像神的透过你教导
God's love.
或是神的爱透过你展现出来
And it is very different.
这其实是不太一样的
And I believe that on Pentecost, that's what we need to learn.
所以这就是五旬节在这五旬节当中我们需要去学习的部分
That we open our heart completely to God.
我们要展开我们的心我们完全向神来敞开
And say, Lord, fill me.
向神说神啊就是充满我吧
When we get baptized,
当我们就是受洗的时候
it represents that our old nature dies.
这代表的是说我们的老我死了
Our anger,
我们的怒气
Our greed,
我们的贪婪
Our fear,
我们的恐惧
And we resurrect and we want to be filled with the Holy Spirit.
所以当我们再度站起的时候我们希望是领受圣灵的充满
We hope it's like miracle happened in one second.
我们希望那一秒钟就那个神迹就展现了。
But most of the time it takes longer, right?
但其实有些时候，其实那个神迹要展现还需要蛮长的时间。
It's a growth process.
这是一个很长需要成长的一个时间。
So becoming a family.
来，所以成为一个家人的话
，is a growth process.
也是一个需要成长的一个过程。
That we learn about other people's weakness.
当我们去学习或者是认识别人的这个软弱的时候
that we know our own weakness that we also know our own weakness
我们同时也会知道我们自己的软弱
that we commit to grow
那我们彼此就承诺我们一起来成长
commit to love
我们一起来彼此承诺相爱
and then step by step this trust will grow
那所以这样透过一步一步的这样的一个了解我们其实那个信靠就会慢慢的建造起来
we have time
我们很有时间
That's okay.
而且
It's like when you walk, climb a mountain.
这就好像我们去爬山一样
I went to the Yusan two months ago, right?
好我曾经去过玉山嘛
And I hardly made it.
我几乎没有办法登顶
I was very tired.
我非常累啊
I needed the encouragement of many people.
我需要很多人的鼓励
But I knew if I just put one feet at a time,One time I will be up there.
那我知道，我只要一次一步，一次一步，我一定可以登顶。
Once you move,
一旦你移动了
，Once you put this into action,
一旦你开始行动了
，You will come closer to the goal.
你就会越来越接近目标。
So when we commit ourselves to growth,
所以当我们承诺说我们要成长的时候
，And see our goal is to trust each other.
如果我们的目标是我们彼此要能够建立那个信靠的时候
，Becoming a family,
成为家人的时候
，Then we will reach the goal.
那我们就会达到那个目标。
The dangerous thing is that we give up.
最危险的事情是我们放弃了。
If we say, I will never trust you.
如果我们说我绝不会信靠你。
Or I will leave this relationship.
或者是说我要离开这样的关系。
You hurt me so much, I don't want to talk to you anymore.
或者是你伤害我这么深，我不想再跟你说话了。
Happens very easily.
这其实非常容易发生的。
Why?
为什么？
Because we want to protect ourselves.
因为我们都想要保护自己。
Because we are fragile.
因为我们都非常的脆弱。
So I encourage you.
所以我要鼓励你们。
Never say never.
绝不要说不。
Okay, that's very important.
这非常重要。
You can take a rest.
你可以稍微休息一下。
You know, like in the marriage conflict.
或者就比如说在婚姻的这个冲突当中。
We often encourage people just to say, just take a time out.
我们都常鼓励这个配偶说，哎，稍微冷静一下，就是稍微
休息五分钟。
就是
OK，
在吵的时候。
Let's take a rest from fighting for 5 minutes.
Yeah, 就是停五分钟啊，在吵。
Regain strength.
那这五分钟呢，我们可以再重新的得到力
量。But not regain strength to fight again.
不是说重新得力再来猛攻这样。
But regain strength to forgive.
而是重新得到那个力量，然后愿意来原谅。
To accept.
来去接受。
You know, usually we want others to think like we think.
因为有些时候我们都希望别人照着我们的想法来做。
You know, we say, I don't know why you always react like this. I would not react like this.
我不知道为什么你会这样反应，我的话就不会这样做啊。
And the other person says, but I react like this, so.
那另外一个人就说，那我就是这样反应，你想怎样吗？
Can we bear that?
我们可以这样做吗？
Bear it?
我们可以彼此互相的容忍吗？
Yeah, this is very important.
这个很重要。
It needs strength.
这是需要力量的。
It needs God's strength.
这需要神的介入。
The more we connect with God,
我们更多，如果我们越多跟神的这样的连接，
or the more God is in us,
或者是神在我们里面越来越多的时候，
we are able not to run away, but to come closer.
那我们就不会是逃避这样的一个冲突，而是更愿意去解决这样的冲突。
To say, I can wait.
然后跟对方说，我愿意等。
I'll be patient.
我会愿意有耐心的等候。
I'm willing to listen.
我也愿意来倾听。
I'm willing to get to know you better.
我也愿意来更多的了解你。
I'm willing to change.
我也愿意来改变。
And if we develop this way,
如果我们是这样来发展的话，
other people will feel very comfortable in our presence.
那别人就会觉得我们的同在，或是我们在的时候，他们会其实会比较舒适。
Like my own pastor.
像我的自己的牧
师，
对，赵牧师。
I feel so safe when he's here.
他在的时候，我就会感觉非常的这个安全。
For one thing, because he likes to hug, right?
因为他非常喜欢拥抱。
So if he hugs, it's already an action, right?
因为当他去拥抱我的时候，这种就是一种关爱的行为。
I don't know if you ever try to hug a person and this person just freeze.
我不知道你有没有这种经验，就是你想要拥抱一个人的时候，可是那个人却硬邦邦的。
He's still standing, but you hug him.
他就是会这样很硬邦邦的，当你要拥抱他的时候。
Yeah, right. You immediately feel, oh, I come too close.
那你马上知道，哎呦，我真的太靠近他了。
But that's okay.
但没有关系。
But you know, with my pastor, he hugged me, and we feel so close, and I just feel I can be who I am.
当我的牧师拥抱我的时候，我就会觉得我很安全，所以我就可以成为那个原来的那个我。
Even I say my problem.
甚至在我说我自己的困难的时候。
Or sometimes maybe he says, there's a meeting, you should go there.
甚至牧师有那个牧师的牧师说，有一个聚会你可以去。
And I said, I think I cannot go.
我不能去。
And he don't say, oh, that's not good.
他不会说，你不能去，这样不好
啊。He says, it's okay, just do what God wants you to do.
他说没有关系，你就做神要你做的。
Very easy，
非常的容易。
I feel very safe，
我也感觉到非常安全。
And I think we all can become such people。
我想我们都可以成为这样的人。
Where other people feel safe，
让别人感觉到舒服的人。
When they feel safe，
当他们感觉到这样安全的
话 ，their heart is open，
那他们的心就愿意敞开。
We can teach them，
那我们就可以有机会教导他们。
So I believe when the Spirit fills us。
所以我相信圣灵充满我们的时候
，God is in us，
神就在我们当中。
You know, baptism means completely filled。
所以那个受洗那个字呢，其实代表着是一个完全的一个 充满。
And sometimes Bible even means mentions the overflow.
所以甚至这个字有些时候代表是一个满溢出来的一个状况。
And that's what we want to see.
这就是我们要寻求的。
That God fills us.
让神充满我们。
That it flows over.
让神充满我们到满溢，我们可以
分出来。His love flows over.
就像那个爱充满到可以满溢出来。
His patience flows over.
或者是那个耐心可以满溢出来。
For a leader, this is very important.
对一个领导者是很重要的。
Because often leaders, they walk at the front, right?
因为对领导者来讲非常重要，因为他们是站在前面的那一位。
Often they don't have anybody to turn to.
有些时候领导者其实是没有人可以去寻求帮忙的。
They only have God.
因为他们只有神。
So if their relationship to God is not good enough,
所以如果他们跟神的关系不够紧密的时候
then they often turn around
那他们就会就是转头就走
and try to defend themselves
或者是透过自己的防卫机制来为自己辩解
but I share yesterday with our cell group leaders
所以我昨天跟小组长的分享有提到
I said as a leader we first need to look at the mirror
所以身为这个领导者我们必须要先看看自己先反思自己
If our followers have problems,
如果我们的追随者有问题的话
It's not their problem,
那其实不是他们的问题
It's my problem,
这是我的问题
Because I'm the leader,
因为我是那个领导者
So what can I do?
所以我可以做些什么呢
Turn to God,
我就是回转向神
So today is Pentecost,
所以今天是五旬节
This filling of the Spirit,
那个圣灵的充满
is important for every Christian.
对每一个基督徒都是很重要的。
When God lives in us,
如果神住在我们当中
and overflows,
如果是满溢出来的
you will be a different person.
你就会是不一样的人。
And that's why this was so important before the church started that they waited on God.
这个是在教会还没有开始之前他们在等候神的时候神赐下的。
And when they received the Holy Spirit,
当他们这个接受圣灵的时候
they had something they now could give.
那他们就有东西可以分享出来。
And then they go and start many churches.
所以他们就出去，然后成立很多这个教会。
So in the third point of your outline.
所以在第三点，就是在我们的生命当中的时候。
Pentecost in our life, what does it mean?
那五旬节在我们的生命当中有什么意义呢
？First of all, I said it should also be a harvest festival.
所以这对我们来讲同样也是一个收割的意义。
Give thanks for the fruit in your life.
那我们就是要献上我们的感恩就是神所赐给我们的我们献上感恩。
Well, we should see the positive in our life.
我们就要看到正向的东西。
Because when you harvest as a farmer, if you go and harvest your field,
如果我们是像农夫如果去收割的时候
there are also some fields that are destroyed.
那一定会有一些那个田地那个地方是被
Sometimes by the heavy rain, right?
有些时候是大雨破坏的。
That's always the fear. If the rain is too heavy, maybe all what the farmer sow is rotten.
那有些时候那个雨太大，所以有些地方的那个它那个种子就已经被那个雨腐烂掉了。
Or sometimes too much sun.
或者有些时候是太多的阳光。
Too dry.
太干了。
So many different reasons.
是有很多不同的原因。
But usually there's a good harvest and there's maybe some.There wasn't any harvest at all.
所以有些时候是丰收的年啊，有些时候就可能不是那么的好。
Where do we focus on?
所以我们要焦点在哪一个部分
？We should focus on the good fruit.
我们应该要焦点在那个丰收的那个。
Give thanks to God what he give us.
就是向神感恩，就是神给我们那个部分。
See the gift that He gives you.
See
the gift.
那去看到他给我们的那个礼物。
Every one of you have gifts from God.
You mean 恩赐吗
？Everyone. Yeah.
好，所以每一个人都有这个恩赐，就从神而来的恩赐。
Every one of you has strength.
那每个人也都有从神而来的这样的一个力量。
Don't say, yeah, everyone except me.
不要说每一个人都有，就我没有这样。
No, everyone.
每一个人都有。
God can use you.
神可以使用你。
But you need to trust Him.
但是你要信靠他
Walk with him.
要与他同行
Believe.
要相信
And often it's about our own posture and perception.
有些时候是关乎我们的这个姿态，还有就是我们的领受
Our body language is very important.
我们的这个身体的语言很重要。
If I ask you, how does a depressed person look like?
那如果我问你说一个忧郁的人，他的那个身形会是长什么样子的话
？What would you say?
你会怎么说
？Does he look like this?
你觉得他会这样子站着吗？就是会很很感觉很有力量。
Maybe not, right?
也许不是这样吗
？Probably head a little bit down.
也许是头会低低的。
Shoulder a little bit down.
然后这个肩膀会低下垂下。
Here a little bit down.
然后这个腰这个地方会稍微垂一点。
Okay. Well. Let's make an exercise.
来运动一下。
Let's stand up all together.
大家一起起立，我们来运动一下。
抱歉。
抱歉。
You don't have to, but if you want to, you can make this exercise.
你不一定要做，但如果你愿意的话，我们一起来做一下。
Can you try to straighten up your body?
你可以试着挺直你的身体吗？
怎么做？
怎么做
？There's one trick.
好，有一个技巧。
屁股粘在一起。
屁股要粘在一起。
Then you stand strong. Then let's all raise our hand like this.
来，大家就一起伸起手。
Look up.
Look up. 就是往上看。
And then smile.
然后微笑。
Okay, good. Then don't change your position.
不要改变你的姿势哦。
Now try to be depressed.
不要特别的
Now try to be depressed. Don't change your position. Don't change your smile, but try to be depressed.
你现在不要改变你的姿势，但是你要有忧郁的感觉。
Try to be depressed.
你试着忧郁看看。
Okay. 好，谢谢。
谢谢，好，请坐。
It's very difficult, right?
你有发现这样的姿势要忧郁有点难吧？
是吗？Yeah. So posture is very important.
所以其实我们那个姿态很重要。
But of course, it's not enough. It's not just the posture.
那不是只有那个姿势重要而已。
It's an inner disposition.
其实是更关乎那个
我。How your heart is, what direction your heart is.
其实更重要的是我们内心，我们怎么样去呈现我们那样的一个姿势。
What do you focus on?
那我们的焦点在哪里
？You can focus on the harvest that didn't.Grow well.
那也许你会，如果你选择去看到那个没有办法收割的那块田地
，or you can focus on the good harvest.
还是你可以就是焦点在你可以收割的那一片好的田地。
Some people say this is half empty.
好，有人觉得这是有空一半，
some,
水没有装满。
Some people say it's half full.
有些人就觉得它是一半满的。
What is it?
那你觉得是什么
？Half empty or half full?
你觉得是一半满还是一半空？
谁觉得 half empty?
谁觉得一半空？
谁觉得 half full?
谁觉得一半满？
好，谁觉得不一样？ Anybody? Any other option?
有没有其他的选择或是选项？
No?
没有
啊。I tell you, it's completely full.
我告诉你，这完全是满的。
It's completely full.
这是完全满的。
One part is water, one part is air.
因为一半是水，一半是空气，
所以全满的。
这是完全满的。
That's positive.
这就是一个正向的态度。
Okay, it's a joke. Okay.
这是一个玩笑。
But it can be in your life.
但是这在你的生命中是可以发生的。
Okay. If you see some difficulties in your life,
如果在生命中你去看到那个困难的话
，you can still say my life is rich.
你还是可以说我的生命是富足的。
Because I have some challenges.
因为我有一些挑战。
It's good for me.
这些挑战其实对我来讲是好的。
Because I can use my strength, I can use my gift.
因为我可以用我的这样的一个神赐给我的恩赐来面对。
Recently, people, you know, I just here for two or three days, but I had a lot of sharing already.
因为这两三天我已经有很多的分享了。
So and some people say, sorry, Pastor, to bother you about this.You know?
有些人就来说，牧师不好意思，我要麻烦你了。
But I always say, no, that's my job.
没关系，这我工作。
I love to do that.
我喜欢这样做。
I love to help.
我喜欢帮忙的。
Just tell everything to me.
好，就是把所有事情跟我讲吧。
I don't mind.
我不介意的。
That's why I'm here.
那就是我为什么在这的原因。
And I feel very encouraged.
因为我在这样的状况，我其实我觉得我反而是很受到激励的。
And if I can help people,
如果我可以帮助人的话
，most of the time I also learn something.
因为在帮助人过程，我也学到一些东西的。
So, look at the positive side.
所以要看到正向那一面。
Give thanks to the Lord for the fruit.
向神感恩那出熟的果子。
This should be our attitude.
这应该是我们的态度。
Overflow of what God has given to us.
我们要将神给我们的满意出来。
And coming back to what we said at the beginning,
就回到我们之前说的。
to declare that you are rich.
我们去宣称你是富足的。
Okay, now rich doesn't mean, okay, I have a lot of money.
富足不是说你很有钱的。
Because, as you know, some people have more money than you, but they think they are poor.
因为就如同我们大家知道，有些人很有钱，但是他就觉得他自己很穷。
They think they still need more.
他而且甚至他觉得他还需要更多的钱。
So it's not about how much money you have.
所以那个不是在于你有多少钱。
It's how you think about it.
而是你自己认为你的那个有是不是富足
？And God give us this exercise.
所以神也给我们这样的一个训练。
Give the first fruit.
要给出那个出熟的果子。
Then harvest.
然后收割。
Take it.
然后收。
And leave something for the poor.
但是我们还是要留一些给那个有需要的人。
I think we all can do that.
我想我们都可以这么做吧。
If you are working.
如果你是在工作的话。
What salary you have?
你有多少薪水
？First, give your tithe.
首先呢，先十一奉献。
Then the rest you take.
那你把剩余的给收着。
Then maybe there's something left you still can give to the poor.
也许你还可以留一下一些金钱可以分享给有需要的人。
If you do that,
如果你这样做的话
，you feel you're rich.
那你就会觉得你很富足。
Because what is rich?
因为到底什么是富足呢
？Rich is you have more than you need.
富足的意思就是你拥有的超过 你所想的。
So it's a very good trick how to become rich.
所以这个要成为那个有钱啊，就富足啊，其实
有一个技
巧。你想要富足吗
？Adjust your expense.
所以要
adjust your expense.
所以要去调整你的花费。
Okay, just spend less than you earn.
所以要花的比你这个。就是你花的要比你支出的要，应该是说，你支出的要比你花的少，
是吗？帮他一下好不好？Just spend less than your salary, you know?
OK, 好，你花的要比你的薪水要
少一点 ，OK, 对不对？Then you have leftover.
那你就会有余了。
You can tithe.
那你就可以有这个十一奉
献，
或者你也可以给予。
You have more than enough.
你就会拥有这个。
You have more than enough.
你就会more than enough. 你就会有的超过你所想的。那这样翻好不太好。
很难。大家一起帮忙好不好？
你就会有你。
你们都了解对不对？
对对对。
英文都了解。More than enough.
More than
Tell your neighbor more than enough.
More than enough.
Okay. More than enough.
你就会。比足够的还要多。
Amen, Amen, Amen. Okay, so I think that okay, 鼓励你，鼓励他一下，好不好 ？We are family, we trust each other, right?
Yeah, 我们是家人，所以我们彼此信
号。You feel safe?
对，我非常感觉到安全。谢谢大家。
Amen, Hallelujah. This is wonderful. Amen. Praise the Lord. Okay, maybe worship team can get ready.
那个敬拜团可以准备。
Yeah, so I think today we learn.
好，所以我想我们今天学习到了。
From that festival of Pentecost.
从这个五旬节我们学到了一些东西。
When we wait on God.
当我们等候神的时候。
He will give us His Word. He will give us His Spirit.
他同时会给我们他的话语，也同时给他的圣灵的引导。
And He not just give a little bit.
而且他不是只给一点点。
He gives more than we need.
他给远超过我们所需要的。
Amen. So let's pray.
好，所以我们来祷告。
Amen. Yes, Lord, we are thankful.
是的，主，我们非常的感恩。
For all the good things that you give us.
我们感谢你所给我们的东西。
For the harvest.
主啊，谢谢你给我们这样的一个收割。
And Lord, today we also learn about that trust needs time.
主，今天我们也同时学习到信靠其实是需要时间的培养。
Becoming a family needs time.
成为家人也是需要时间的。
But we don't want to give up.
但是我们不放弃。
We want to learn more.
我们需要学到更多。
About ourselves.
我们希望学习更多有关我们自己。
About others.
也关乎别人。
Where we need to change.
我们哪里需要改变。
Where we need to cover others' weaknesses.
什么时候我们必须去遮盖别人的这样的软弱
？Lord, help us.
主帮助我们。
Teach us.
来教导我们。
Today is the Pentecost Festival.
今天是五旬节。
We are reminded that we have your Holy Spirit.
我们被提醒，这是你圣灵降临的日子。
That when we believe in Jesus,
当我们信靠神的时候
then God lives in us.
主，你就带领我们。
Thank you that you live in us.
谢谢你住在我们当中。
Thank you, we can depend on you.
谢谢主，我们能够依靠你。
I think it's a good time that maybe individually we can come before the Lord.
现在是一个就是个人来到神面前的一个很好的一个时刻。
And you can, if you want to have this posture, you can open your hands.
如果你想要有那个比较正向的姿势，你可以打开你的手。
And like the hands in a posture that you receive from God.
这样你可以双手张开，表示你愿意领受神的给予的那样的一个知识。
The Lord, I receive your Spirit.
主，愿你真的让我领受你的圣灵。
And so that in your life is enough space for the Spirit, of course, you need to let go of your own.
主啊，如果我愿意你更多的充满我，主，你教导我，真的让我生命真的有更多的一个空间来让你能够来占据。
So I let go of my own strength.
我放掉我自己的这样的一个力量。
My own ideas.
我自己的想法。
And I'm open to receive from you, Lord.
我愿敞开，愿主来，真的是让我能够更多的领受。
Fill me with your Spirit.
主啊，愿你的圣灵来充满我。
Fill me with your love.
用你的圣灵的爱来充满我。
Fill me with purpose.
主，用你的圣灵来带领我生命。能够有一个属你的目的。
Fill me with your patience.
主，愿你来充满，用你的这样的一个耐心来充满我。
Let me become a person where people feel safe.
让我能够成为一个人，而能够带给别人是一个舒服、安全的这样的一个人。
Thank you, Lord.
主，谢谢你。
Hallelujah.
谢谢主。
As we sing this song together,
当我们一起唱这首歌的时候
just spend time with God.
我们就花一点时间与神同在
Let him speak to your heart.
让他自己来向你说话
Amen.
Amen.
神灵请你来充满我心我需要你恩膏充满我灵神灵啊，我好爱你，我的力让你牵引，而每一天我要更深爱你。
神灵，
神灵，请你来充满我的心，我需要你恩膏充满我里。神灵啊，我好爱你，我的灵让你牵引，而每一天我要更深爱你，我要追求你主，我将生命献给你，牵引我更亲近你，你大能更新我里。我要追求你主，我将生命献给你，牵引我更亲近你，你大能更新我灵，无人能与你相比。主，我仰望你的容颜，我敬拜你，在灵与真理。生命献给你，牵引我更亲近你，你 圣灵里。
哈利路亚，我们敬赞牧师为我们祷告。
主，我们感谢你，你真在十字架上为我们受死，也在复活的生命当中，使我们更经历你的大能。主，今天是母亲节的纪念的日子，主，愿主的灵充满在我们的心里面，也在我们的教会当中自由的运行，更新我们的心，刚强我们的灵，好让我们能够一生来服侍你，来跟随你的时候，我们要经历你自己生命复活的大能。愿主自己的恩典慈爱永远与我们同在。祷告靠耶稣基督的名，阿们。
谢谢牧师，请坐。Usually after the service on the left side, we have some people, they are willing to serve you.
在这个左手边这个地区呢，我们有一些同工可以来服侍你。如果你是
If you're first time here,
如果你是第一次来到这里的
话， welcome you.
我们可以在这边欢迎你。
But even if you're long time here and you see nobody really talk to me,
如果你来这边很久了，然后从来还没有人跟你说过话，你也欢迎来到这。
You also can come here.
对，你也欢迎来到这。
Or if you want to find a cell group suitable to you,
如果你想要找小组加入的话，也欢迎来这边。
Also can come here. Okay, so I wish you a wonderful Pentecost Sunday.
祝福大家有一个愉快的五旬节。
May God bless you.
愿神祝福大家。
See you on Tuesday for prayer meeting.
星期二祷告会见。
Or Friday for cell group.
或者礼拜五小组见。
Or next Sunday.
或是下个主日见。
God bless you.
愿神祝福大家。
Amen.
谢谢。